Welcome back to Whisper Gaming ASMR, and this episode is the fifth of my, I don't know if playthrough's the right word, I guess it is, the fifth episode of me playing the open beta for Diablo 4, and in this episode we're going to try to do more of the main storyline quests. Tarnished luster, and I was just walking around and noticed this icon, and there's a purveyor of curiosities. It looks like this is where you spend whatever those things are called. They had a weird name. Where are they? They had such a weird name. Not like super weird, but sucks. Let's do another one. Let's do gloves. Yeah. At least it's better. Well, you know what? That go to skill assignment to equip something. I missed that. You know what? Let's switch out. Let's try werewolf then. Class 10% chance to attack twice. Claw applies 18 poison damage over 6 seconds. I don't know. Yeah, this one seems better because it's like guaranteed, I guess. Okay, and then we will also... get rid of those. Second and third attack also perform a dash. In addition, shreds critical. Okay. Yeah, let's do that one. You can... oh, okay. So we are now trying out a werewolf build, apparently, because of that one chest piece. Reduce the cooldown of blood hell by 1 second. You gain 3 sounds kind of cool to have. Some wolves deal 20% increased damage. Fine. Yeah, nice. So now we have a bunch of poison stuff. And we have a heal. I guess not a bad use of the curiosities. Let's see. Is there anything else? Are there rings? What is my like worst thing? Yeah, let's try an axe. That's 50 though, it's kind of expensive. Let's do a cap. Yeah. Get something shitty. That's still better than mine. But let's try it. Let's. Yeah. What is intelligence? I don't even know what the stats do. Oh, it's fitting though, it is a wolf, so that's kind of sick. Oh, like a little bit of a boring start to this video, but hopefully will pay off in the long run if my game doesn't crash right there. Okay. Let's salvage that. All this other stuff, and then let's go do some questing after a sip of tea. Okay. And looks like there's an exit out this way. This game's definitely more laggy in town. I can't tell if it's because my PC is old or if it's like an internet thing. I am running on a GTX 980 Ti, which surprisingly still seems to work pretty well for being so old. Okay, I kinda do like the feel of a werewolf. It's definitely a lot. Attack animations feel a lot faster, so that's kind of cool. Unfortunately, I only have 12 gigabytes of RAM in this computer. I don't even know where I have. Okay, that's pretty sick. I have another 4 gigabyte stick of RAM somewhere, but I don't know if I was like messing something up or some type of weird glitch, but whenever I would install the other stick of RAM, my computer would like not boot up. So my solution was just to stick with 12 gigs. At some point I do want to upgrade this computer because it's getting pretty old. But I don't game enough to justify the cost, especially with how expensive graphics cards are right now. Is this channeled? Do I have to hold it down? I'm gonna waste some and just see. I don't know. I won't even do it without enemies here. like the poison aspect of these attacks. That's pretty cool. Well, might as well check out this cellar while I'm here. Maybe I'll get something good out of it. So do I have to hit it three times, or do I hit it once? And it does three attacks. I think I have to hit it three times. Let's see what's in here. Purge the cellar. Classic throat slitters. That would suck if that's what you're known by. You must be kind of a piece of shit if your whole identity is around slitting people's throats. Let's see. Will this just give me stuff, or is there gonna be an ambush? Classic. Fool me once. That was the wrong button. And I feel bad when they're humans compared to monsters and demons and stuff like that. Does that technically make me a racist? I'm not sure. That was not a good joke. Oh shit. Goddamn. They heard my joke. They did not approve. Is pretty sweet. Okay. Kinda glad I got that chest piece, not just because it... Is it legendary? Is that what it is? Yeah, legend. Glad that it got me to try out werewolf, because I think I do like it better than werebear. Shit. It's kind of weird to have these human enemies just like chilling out here with all these monsters and demons. What does this guy's day look like? Just hanging out with a bunch of orcs that don't attack him for some reason. Hanging out with some orcs and an arsonist. That seems like a not an ideal crew of people to hang out with. Someone should make a YouTube series, or some type of series of like what a day in the life of one of these mobs looks like, just like waiting for one of these, I guess, heroes, whatever you'd call my character, to show up, just like hanging out in the snow. bunch of monsters and arsonists. Wonder if they have conversations or small talk or play games or anything while they're waiting for people like me to show up. Okay, what do I want? 10% bonus damage. Yeah, that seems like you can't really go wrong with that. Is that another druid? Yeah. Is it, or is that a barbarian? That cloak is like throwing me off. Okay, well, I'm right back to where I started, so that was not the right way to go. Running around in circles. Fucking arsonist. And what I get one to say plague tongue. Oh, got some bears. Oh god, those actually do a lot of damage. As much as me. Pilgrim's Journal, priest. Matt Bay says, I am ready, I shall leave. Margrave at dawn, the journey will be long, but my faith is endless. Light grants me safe passage to the monastery that I may better know your grace within its hallowed halls. Oh god. I was drinking my tea, so I was playing one-handed right there. It does not look like the light granted him very safe passage to the monastery based on how dead he looks, so that's not ideal. But I will complete his quest for him, or at least let them know that he's dead. What's going on down here? Like, what is this marker? An ancient siphon? There's nothing here. I don't know if that's a glitch or I'm like missing something. Okay, never mind. Here we go. Survive the enemy assault. I gotta kill things inside here, shit. God. is a little bit fucked up that I'm just killing a bunch of monsters that look exactly like me. Nice, more murmuring opals. Sounds like something that'd be at, like, Rick and Morty. Got some murmuring opals. Okay. Don't think it's worth switching out for 12 armor. Oh, this does... This actually does give me one rank of blood owl. You know, I'm just gonna keep the one I have. I can upgrade it. Cellar. Giant bats, those are new. And some type of shrine. Oh, a gold shrine. Let's get that. That slinger had some health. Strength has been increased by 2 for all characters on this realm. If 30% chance to gain 20, okay, that's barbarian only. Sorcerer, I do want to try out a sorcerer. I didn't watch the video, but I saw. I saw a video, just the headline that said that the sorcerer is like completely broken in this game. So, would be interesting to check out and see if that's the case. Oh, there's this other, the whole reason I came over here in the first place. Not be in werewolf form to use that. was it just not working for some other reason? Scythe, is that for necromancers? Yeah. Necromancer, that's a class I also really want to check out. I mentioned in another video, that was my other, like, I guess that'd be my secondary class I played in Diablo 2, was the necromancer. But, yeah, druid is what I got furthest into the game with. I think later they added a necromancer, I'm pretty sure. Or maybe it was in the base game. Yeah, they definitely did. Later they added a necromancer to Diablo 3. In the original, before the DLC, it was the witch doctor, I think, kind of took the place of the necromancer. But yeah, they definitely had a necromancer. I think that's what I played in Diablo 3. I started with a crusader, and then when necromancer came out, I switched to the necromancer. So I might as well try to make my way to the side objective first. Also confused about this, if there's a day and night cycle, or if some areas are just always day and some areas are always night. I haven't figured that out yet. Outlook on life, in my opinion. Let me guess, he wants me to go kill a bunch of things and then come back and I'll get some more herbs. This guy have to say, what is happening here? I feel a sneeze coming. It's like you have a sneeze and then it doesn't come and you just kind of feel like it's like stuck. Feels like it's stuck in my nose. Not ideal. And now this guy's following me around. What are we doing? How do I see my eyes? This guy's kind of a dick, seems like. Maybe a dick, definitely condescending or pretentious. Has Parathan been around? Ew, what the fuck is going on in here? Why does he have a chopped up dude on his... swing it. Let's do another one. Why not? I cannot swing that. Armor vendor. Last guy, see if he's seen this. Parathan, I'm looking for Parathan. I think there's a chance Parathan might be dead. See, you're injured. Do you need help? Sure what I'm doing, but I'm sure it's run to a location, click or kill something, and run back. I'm sure I'll figure it out. Okay, it looks like Parathan's last known location is on our way, so that's convenient. Seems like a bit of a knucklehead, not someone I would want to cross paths with. Kinda sucks to be his brother, I guess. Are we gonna kill Parathan? Oh, is this the freaking... this the hideout where I just murdered all those guys anyway? I probably already killed him. But I guess I will kill him again. this guy, that sucked. Also like to know what job title it falls under to come up with the names for all these enemies. Also, I apologize if my commentary and ranting suck tonight. I feel like they're a little lackluster. I think that happens when I record a bunch of videos back to back. There's like only so much that I can, I don't know how to word this. Talking to myself alone in a room, I feel like the quality declines after doing it for like 2 hours straight, so I should probably limit the amount of times that I record a bunch of videos back to back. Unless it's a game that has like a lot of stuff I can comment on as I'm playing. Because I do think my commentary quality suffers a little bit, but maybe I'm being too hard on myself. So, again, always open to feedback in the comments if you think my commentary in this one sucked. A pale tongue, that's what it's called. I thought it said plague tongue when I got the other one. A pale tongue. I wonder how that happens. I feel like tongue, well, I guess if all the blood runs out of the tongue, it'd be pale, but I feel like I never really notice how tan someone's tongue is. See, that's the quality of commentary right there, where I'm like, why did I just say that? That was so stupid. Maybe enjoy stupid commentary like that. Who knows? There's an audience for everything. Let's see if there's anything over here before we help this guy murder his brother. Also, feedback for Blizzard, they could probably improve that animation when my wolves jump on something. It's a little bit goofy. Let's see that again. It just like lifts the character models and drops them. They don't even like really jump. Smuggler's key. Oh, I think I probably needed that to get into the door, but I never even tried it, so I did need the smuggler's key, so good thing I came in and explored over here. Anyway. Wow, my guy is covered in a lot of blood. Shit. almost to level 15. There's a little over 5 more levels to get that sweet, sweet wolf pup cosmetic in like 3 months. Granted, I buy the game. It sucks how expensive video games are getting. I can't believe we're to the point now where they're $69 a piece for the standard one, which kind of at this age, I don't really see the benefits of like the more expensive ones, like for a few cosmetics and stuff that I'm gonna like, what's the point of starting the game with the best cosmetics already and a bunch of bonuses? Like, I was looking at the different package levels for Diablo 4. Spirit Boons quest available. Shift C, what is that? Unlock every boon from every spirit to gain access to spirit bonding. This lets you activate an additional boon. Looking at the different things you got for the different levels of game, and I think if you buy like the $90 version of Diablo 4, you get like a boosted season pass or something, which if they charge for the season pass every season, that'll be annoying since it's a $70 game. Like at that point, I guess it's a live service, but I don't know, it just seems a little greedy. But I'm like, what's the... So you're paying more money to play the game less? Like, that doesn't make any sense. Like, I just don't understand all these boosts and stuff when it's like, you're spending $90 on the game because you, in theory, like the game so much you're willing to spend $90. Like, what's the point of giving someone less of a reason to play it because they get, like, 20 levels for free? I don't know if I'm making any sense, but I just feel like the monetization of the gaming industry is very stupid a lot of the times, and also, I don't want to go say unethical, because I think that's too extreme. I just can't think of the right words, because it's 11:15, but... I guess shady is a better vague term to describe it. The monetization of the gaming industry is shady at best, I would say. Especially with, like, Blizzard, I will say, puts out pretty decent games, it seems, but... I know things I've heard about their company culture is pretty bad. And now I think they're owned by Activision. Which I guess, actually, I don't know that much about Activision. But... yeah, I don't know. Again, that's why I like playing that game Deep Rock Galactic, because I think they do a lot of things right. They're monetized, like it's only, I think, a $40 game, typically on sale, and their season passes are always free. Oh, Outlaw Sharpshooter, okay. Oh boy. Can this guy be immobilized? God, I do not like the vulnerable status effect. Looks like I cannot immobilize him, but I do think that poisons him more when I use the creep on him. can't get over how bad the wolf animation looks. There's that guy. What the hell are they doing over there? Just sitting down, chilling, waiting for me to do all the friggin' work. Justice. I also just realized I'm almost 50 minutes into this episode and did not even get to where the next mainline quest is because I got so distracted. So, classic. Classic me. Guy's gonna throw away his whole life for his crappy brother. I mean, I guess it's his brother, so I can't blame him, but kind of a shitty situation to be in. No. I'm gonna murder both of you and hope you have legendary loot. Just kidding. Apparently I can't do that. Check it out just to be safe. Oh God, these headphones are also starting to hurt my ears a little bit after wearing them for 2 hours straight. This is almost 100% going to be a waste of time, I think. Oh, nice. A common staff and a common ring. Glad I didn't miss those. There's another world event. Let's see, is it the same one that I've done before? Jar of Souls. Slay the monsters, disturbing the jar. Because these freebooters are considered monsters. drop multiple souls. I need more souls. More people, I think. Ever. I got a normal radiant chest. Crude diamond. Oh, there are a bunch of freaking souls over here. God damn, are you fucking kidding me? Are you fucking kidding me? Whatever. Whatever. And let me guess. I was gonna be cursed, I was gonna have to fight enemies. And there's gonna be no one for me to fight while I have this buff. The fuck was that? That thing hits pretty hard. And another town unlocked. I wonder if this is where I do the quest to get a mount. I really don't know why I care about these transmogs when this thing's gonna run out pretty soon. Following that line of reasoning, I don't know why I care about any of this. I guess I'll leave this for the next episode. There's no point to start right now. Let's sell some stuff. Wow, those don't sell for shit. Started it with one of these purveyors of curiosity. I'll ask the innkeeper, does he have anything to sell? No, nope. Just some information. You really want a rare cap. Oh, I guess an amulet or a ring would be good. Let's do a ring. God damn it. One more. Give me a rare fucking ring. Ah, shit, I meant legendary. I guess I technically got what I wanted. And used up all my fucking oobles, or whatever they're called. I set out on my pilgrimage. I offered thanks at a roadside shrine and received a blessing for my journey. Give thanks at the shrine. I don't know why I'd read that and be like, I need to go do that too. Kind of a weird quest motivation. You seem troubled. If that woman was Lilith. Oh my god. So, is that just what every town is? Whoever's standing next to that friggin' sign, you just pick up as a follower. this last side quest, and then what kind of services do you provide? Maybe this is where I can increase my health potion charges. This girl, she's gonna follow me around until I complete that, apparently. Oh, let's sell this stuff. Is there a gem person in this town? No gem person. Oh, since I'm almost at an hour, might as well. Oh, is the gem thing still locked? Damn it. I assumed it'd be unlocked now that they randomly started dropping for me. Let's go double check. God, they gotta work on this, like, loading. It's so glitchy. We did not get to the main story quest. Why is it so glitchy in town? But at least we discovered another town and leveled up and did some side quests, so I hope this video wasn't too bad. I feel not super great about my commentary, but what are you gonna do? They can't all be, can't be my best. Hopefully it's more in my head than in reality, but please let me know in the comments, and as always, I just appreciate you spending your time with me. If you liked it, please hit the like button, if that's not too much trouble. If you want to see more, I'd love if you subscribed, and like I always say, if you're trying to fall asleep, I hope you're not hearing any of this, because my video did its job and put you to sleep already. But anyway, thank you again for joining me during this adventure.